everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a quick SEO analysis to show you how you are doing versus your competitors. It's always good to take a look at competitors to see how much better they're doing than you and what they're doing exactly. So this one's going to be quick. We're going to use two different tools here. There should be a free trial for both. This one, the first one we're looking at on the screen right here is called Ahrefs. So let's go ahead and what we want to look at right here is let's go ahead and look at a site that we like. What's a site that I like? So let's go ahead and take a look at quicksprout.com and let's see what they're doing. So Quicksprout's a online marketing blog from Neil Patel, and there's a lot of great information around there. So right here we can see a lot of different metrics and it can get pretty overwhelming. But what we want to look at right now is the number of new backlinks that this site is acquiring. So what we need to do right here is once we put in the site, let's go to the backlink section, let's click on new. And right now you can see the number of new links being acquired each and every day. So these are the number of overall links. And what we want to do is we want to also take a look at one link per domain as well. Because one site can be sending, you know, hundreds of links from a navigation, right? So we want to be looking at each link per domain. So you're basically seeing, for if it's like a college linking to you, you only really want to see that one link coming in. So that's how you want to really count the number of root domains linking to you. So right here you can see Quicksprout, each and every day it's acquiring 22, 13, 12, 10, 16, 7, 14, 9, 15. So now the thing, we would probably want to compare this with a larger, internet marketing site like search engine. So let's just say I'm Quicksprout. So right now, let's say give or take, I'm acquiring 20 new links per day. So let's go ahead and take a look at search engine land and see what's happening exactly. And by the way, if you're showing this to, your internal team, you can make the case that, hey, because this competitor is acquiring a lot more links, we need to do something about this. So you can see right here, search engine land, let's go ahead and click on new backlinks and see what the heck is going on right here. So Ahrefs does take a little time to load. There's a lot more that it can do. And for whatever reason, it seems like search engine land is not pulling up enough links right here. So let's go ahead and try another one. Let's go ahead and try marketing land, see what that pulls up for us, because some of these sites are really big and a tool like this, sometimes Ahrefs might get overloaded by these sites sometimes. So that's what tends to happen, and this one seems to have the same issue right here. So hopefully the third one's a charm. We'll try using a site like Search Engine Watch. So let's give that a shot. Okay, so Search Engine Watch, this looks like we're in business right here. Let's go ahead and click on new. All right, so with Search Engine Land, you can see it's acquiring significantly more links overall per day. It's going up to 1,400 per day. Again, we need to click the one link per domain tab right here. Or not tab. Let's just call it a link. And so keep in mind, Quicksprout is at about 20 links per day. Let's remember that, and then we can get a rough estimate of the average right here for Search Engine Watch. So again, if I'm Quicksprout and I'm going to, let's say I'm a marketing manager, I'm an SEO manager, and I'm going to my VPs or my CMO, here's how I'm going to make the case that they're doing a lot better. So right here we can see Search Engine Watch, the rough number of links per day, it's looking like about 35. So that is a pretty significant jump. I think that's a 75% jump from the what Quicksprout is getting per day. So you can make that case right there, and that's why Quicksprout is getting significantly less traffic than Search Engine Watch. This is how you make the case. And then if you want to layer on even more, if you want to do another competitive analysis right here, what you want to do is you want to go to Open Site Explorer. So let's use the same example, Quicksprout.com, and we can take a look at the link metrics. So let's go ahead and click Compare Link Metrics. We don't need this section yet, and we want to add a bunch of URLs right here. So let's go ahead and add Search Engine Land, let's go ahead and add Marketing Land, let's go ahead and add SearchEngineWatch.com, and let's go ahead and add another one just for good measure. And now we're going to be able to see the competitive metrics. And keep in mind, this is where you want to ideally be screencasting, or you want to be creating a Word document and then making it a PDF to make it look like a nice presentation. So right here, you can see Search Engine Journal has the highest page authority on the site. And QuickSprout is actually doing pretty well. Now, you can look at the follow linking root domains. This is what we want to look at right here. And we can see that Search Engine Journal, basically, QuickSprout is ahead of almost everyone except for Search Engine Watch, I believe. Yep, Search Engine Watch. So Search Engine Watch has 600 more follow linking root domains, and you know they're getting significantly more keywords going to their site. So again, let's go back to the overview right here for Search Engine Watch. Let's see, they have 558K organic keywords. If we look at QuickSprout right now, let's take a look at that. It has 341K keywords. So that's something to take a look at. You know, you can use a tool like this to also look at the top performing pages and look at why these pages are performing so well. So there's a lot that can be done with both Ahrefs and Moz. So make sure you check out these tools. This is how you can do a quick competitive analysis and take it to your superiors, or you know, even make use of it on your own stuff and then figure out what you want to do from a strategic standpoint. So hope this helps, and we'll see you in the next video.